Hello, my name is Trent, and I'll be going over the RS-232 control capabilities of Noventri Suite. The RS-232 feature provides a user with control over an RS-232 device that is plugged into the Noventri SF-100E player. We'll be using Noventri Suite to schedule a command to be executed at a certain time. Before you begin, make sure that you have the proper serial cable specified in the device's manual and that it is connected to the Noventri SF-100E player and your device. To get started, select the Schedule tab in Noventri Suite. This is where the commands will be scheduled. If you aren't already connected to a server, you'll receive a Noventri Server Login dialog box. Enter the correct information and log into the server. Right-click on the schedule workspace and select Insert Command. You will notice a small, solid-colored bullet point appear. Right-click directly on the bullet point and select Edit. You will see a window appear. The device drop-down will let you select which device you want to send commands to. If you click the drop-down and do not see any devices, this indicates that you are using an older version of Noventri Suite that does not come with any preloaded RS-232 devices. Please visit the Noventri Digital Signage Forum to update your version of Noventri Suite to the newest version available. To manually add devices, click the Edit button. This will bring up the Serial Device Editor window, where you can add, import, edit, delete, and export devices. You can also add, edit, and delete commands associated to those devices. Noventri has already created several command lists covering a few specific devices that can be accessed from the forum at the link in the video description. Once you have these lists downloaded, you can add them to your devices by clicking the Import button, then searching for the SCL file. After the file is imported, it will appear in your Device List dropdown. When you select the device, you will now notice that the Device Command List section will have commands loaded. They are listed in alphabetical order by name. The name explains what the command does, and the command column is the actual command being sent to the RS-232 device. Now, if you go back up to the Device List section, you will notice an Edit button in between the Import and Delete buttons. This edit lets you change the device settings. These settings are typically specified in the manual of a device, but not always. The very last field is the command delay. This is the delay that decides how fast a command goes out. If you were to schedule two commands at one time, this would be the set delay in between them. Please note that this delay is in milliseconds, so plan accordingly. We are now able to schedule the commands. Close the Serial Device Editor window and you will now notice that your device is available in the Device drop-down. When you select the device, the Commands field now becomes available. Click on the Edit button next to the Commands field. This is where you will select which commands you would like to schedule and what order you would like them to be sent. Select the command from the command list and click on the right-pointing arrow. This will send the command over to the chosen command section. If you need to remove commands from the list, use the left-pointing arrow. You can also move commands up and down on the list using the two arrows on the right side of the window. This controls which commands get sent first, second, and so on. After you have chosen the commands you want to send, you'll need to set a specific time. In setting these times, please be aware that certain devices have specific timings and that even though the commands may be sent at the time you schedule, the time for the commands to take effect may vary. You have the option of choosing the month, day, and year, as well as the hour, minute, and second. If you would like for the command to play for the entire week at the time you scheduled it, you can click on the Repeat This Sequence All Week option. After you're done, click OK, and your command will be added to the schedule. Finally, assign the schedule to the player, and you have successfully scheduled an RS-232 command. Remember to check out the Noventri Digital Signage Forum for RS-232 command lists and example uses of RS-232 commands. That's all for now. and stay tuned for additional videos covering all the features found inside Noventri Suite.